Hi all. So I'm going to talk about the blood collection vacutainers today, the vials in which we collect blood for sending to the lab for various investigations. So today I have here three vials which have different color of the cap. So this is the red top vial. We also call it as plain vial. We have grey top vial, we also call it as fluoride vial, and the third vial is this, which is EDTA vial, and the color of the cap is lavender, or we say purple. So what is the use of each blood collection container or the vacutainer or blood collection vial? I'll tell you briefly. So this is a plain vial which does not have any additive. It does not have any other compound added to it, or it could have a clot activator. So when we take blood in this vial and we leave it at room temperature in a stand, the cell mass settles down at the bottom and the serum part separates out and it comes above here. And you can centrifuge the tube and separate the serum out. That serum will be used for most of the biochemical investigations. For example, your lipid profile, liver function test, kidney function test, and other tests as well. Okay. So it may not have any additive, or it could have a clot activator which will fasten the process of clot formation, so that you can separate out the serum for analysis. Then talking about this lavender top vial, this has an anticoagulant. Anticoagulant means it will not let the blood coagulate. So it has anticoagulant, which is mostly dipotassium or tripotassium salt of EDTA. EDTA is the basic anticoagulant. So it basically chelates calcium ions. So if you render calcium ions, there are no calcium ions, we know that the blood will not coagulate. So what we get from this vial is whole blood. And whole blood can be used for your hematological investigations, your CBC, of course, and glycated hemoglobin, which goes to biochemistry lab. So what we get here is whole blood. And the third vial that I have here is grey top vial. It has two things in it, sodium chloride and an anticoagulant, which again could be a dipotassium or tripotassium salt of EDTA. Sodium chloride, the role of sodium chloride is to inhibit glycolysis. We usually use this vial for blood glucose estimation, or I should say plasma glucose estimation, because plasma is the most preferred sample for estimating glucose. So if we leave this, if I take sample in this vial and leave it at room temperature, the plasma will separate out and I can use it for analysis for glucose estimation. Why did I use sodium chloride as additive in this vial? Because I had to inhibit glycolysis. For example, a patient of leukemia has a huge count of white blood cells. So I do not want the glucose to be consumed by white blood cells. So I would want the correct estimation of glucose to take place. If I have to make that possible, I have to inhibit the glycolysis by the cells in the blood. So I have used sodium chloride here. And of course, if you are using plasma as your sample, you need you have to have an anticoagulant as well. And that's about the three vials. Besides these, you have some other vials as well. For example, blue top vial is used for coagulation studies, that is prothrombin time and ABTT. And you have green top vial as well, which is heparin is the additive in that vial. You have black top vial as well. In the next video, I'll show you those vials and talk about those. So to summarize, This is for hematological investigations and glycated hemoglobin, plasma glucose estimation, and most of your biochemical investigations wherein you use serum for analysis. Thank you.